Hello friends, welcome to my channel Polymath Agro Solution Services. As we are working on agribusiness, today I am here to discuss about casing soil which is used in the mushroom industry. In this video, we discuss about the various parameters for the mushroom or for the casing soil to be used in the mushroom and how can we sterilize casing soil and different aspects of that. Let's begin with that.
Casing soil as essential part of the total substrate. As we already know that the compost layer is as high as 9 inches. On the top of that, we need to put up a casing layer that must be ranging from 1.5 inches to 2 inches high. This casing layer basically is meant for helping the mushroom transit from the vegetative phase into the reproductive phase. This results into the formation of the button, which is basically a sporophore, and it's the reproductive part of the mushroom development. The main function of the casing layer is the production of mushrooms in quantity while maintaining quality. Casing layer, which is otherwise nutritionally deficient medium, helps uniform fructification and also provides anchorage and essential reserves for developing sporophores of mushrooms. It also acts as water reservoir for developing button, as button contains about 90% of water content. At this time, we need to keep an eye on the other factors as well. In addition to the genetic factors, mushroom mycelial growth and development also depend on microbiological, chemical composition and environmental conditions. Let's have a glance why casing soil is so significant. It protects the compost against desiccation. It supports the mushroom against pests and diseases. It provides support for developing sporophores. It provides a gaseous exchange for development and growth of mushrooms. It also provides increased microbial activity, thereby influencing productivity, product quality, and uniformity. It's important to know what kind of physical and chemical properties a good casing soil should possess. It should have adequate water holding capacity. It must have good porosity. It should always be slightly basic. That means the pH level must be ranging between 7.2 to 8.2. It should have low content of soluble inorganic and organic nutrients. Last but not the least, it should be pathogen and pest free. Plenty of materials used in casing soil are available in the market. They are used both commercially and experimentally in order to attain promising results. A few of them include peat moss, coco peat, farmyard manure, two-year-old spent compost, two-year-old cow dung cakes, vermicompost, rice husk fly ash from shellers, and black soil. Let's have a look at the physical and chemical properties of the casing soil. It's a well-established fact that physical and chemical properties of casing, like water holding capacity, porosity, bulk density, pH, and electrical conductivity, play a very important role during mushroom production. Now we'll talk about each factor in details. The first point is water holding capacity. As far as the yield of the button mushroom is concerned, heavy soils have reported to perform better when compared to light sandy soils. Fine soils cause anaerobic conditions in the compost and reduce the yield. However, the yield of mushrooms is reported to be better with higher water holding capacity of casing. Casing soil contributes water to the fruit bodies, and with the increase in this content, the size and yield of fruit body increases significantly. Delay in the watering at the time of casing alters the mushroom size, which in turn influences the mushroom quality again. Imbalance of moisture availability between the compost and casing layer results in premature opening of the fruit bodies and reduces the fruit body size, clearly indicating the significance of watering during crop production. The amount of water extracted from the casing soil during the fruit body growth is proportional to the weight of fruit bodies. The fruit bodies harvested from watered culture had less dry matter content as compared to unwatered cultures. Another important factor is porosity. An adverse effect on the yield was observed when the soil disintegrated upon watering. forming a crust over the surface of the beds. So it was postulated that the casing must remain porous so that aerobic respiration could be maintained in the compost. With fewer pore spaces occupied by the mycelium, water holding capacity might increase, resulting in a tendency for larger porosity, which is further necessary to maintain the gaseous exchange between the compost surface and the growing room air. Casing materials retain water primarily within their micropores. Porosity has been reported to be more important than water holding capacity. With higher percentage of porosity, there is a reportedly increase in mushroom yield. The next factor is bulk density and particle density. It has been found that casing soil with an apparent density of 0.75 to 0.81 grams per milliliter and true density between 1.5 to 1.6 grams per milliliter can hold sufficient water and also have enough porosity for good growth of mushroom. As far as the pH is concerned, various workers have suggested different ranges of casing pH for good mushroom yield. Good yields of mushrooms has been observed in the casing media having pH ranging between 7.2 to 8.2. Electrical conductivity is a very important point in mushroom production. Besides the pH of the casing, salt concentration of casing layer is another important factor which affects the mushroom yield. It's important for every farmer to know that the salt concentration has always to be low, since if it increases, it will further result in the increase of the electrical conductivity, which is finally going to decrease the pinhead formation, and it's a loss to the mushroom yield. Microbiological properties. In addition to physical and chemical parameters of casing, bacterial microflora is also essential for the commercial fruiting of mushroom. No fructification can develop if sterile casing is used. It was found that bacteria could trigger sporophore formation. An increase in mycelial density, earlier initiation of fruiting, and higher total yield was recorded after spraying the spores of a range of bacteria and yeast on spawned compost before casing and after 1 week of casing. Mushroom mycelium produces self-inhibitory compounds, which are removed by the bacteria, that is Pseudomonas putida, to below a threshold level, permitting the fruit body initiation. The microorganisms in the casing layer play an important role in triggering the fruit body initiation and influencing its development. Pasteurization of casing soil is equally important. Before the preparation of the casing mixture, a disinfection of cleaned floor, machinery, and equipment with 2% of formalin solution is carried out. The effect of this treatment is based on contact action. However, the similar concentration of formalin is used for the pasteurization of casing soil. Spawning in casing. It's the addition of spawn in casing to fasten up the case run. I hope you've understood all about the casing soil as described in this video. Do like and subscribe the channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon for further notifications. Thanks for watching this video.